Hey everyone, so today I'm gonna do a July favorites video, and I didn't do a favorites in June or May, so I feel like I've been majorly slacking on this type of video, which is weird because it's one of my favorite types of videos to do, and I say that every single favorites video, and it's probably really repetitive. But yeah, I really like them because it's easy. You just talk about what you like and what you've been using and you share with other people. So that's what I'm gonna do. So the first product is a product that I have gotten a ton of use out of this month especially, and it's called a Travel Pal, and it's by Shop Go Girl, which is a company I've done a video on before. Their URL is shopgogirl.com. But this is really cool if you travel a lot, which I've been doing this month. The bag itself is a Ziploc bag that is airline approved. It's like the size that your Ziploc bag can be where you can carry it on. And it comes with a bunch of little containers that you can put your products in. So I have my shampoo and conditioner. It comes with three of these and I only have used two. And I need to refill them because they're kind of looking a little bit empty. So this is my shampoo and this is my conditioner. And then it comes with two little containers that look like this that you can put your moisturizer and your eye cream in. And then there are a few things that I haven't used from the pack. It comes with, like I said, a third one of those. And it comes with one that's like a spray bottle that would be great to put brush cleanser in. And the reason I haven't is because I ran out of brush cleaner and I need to get some new ones. But that would be great. That way you have a little brush cleaner with you or eye makeup remover or something like that. And then it comes with two more things. It comes with a little funnel in case you need help pouring your products into the containers. And then it also comes with a little spatula for your moisturizer if you don't like dipping your fingers down into your moisturizer. You can put them all in the Ziploc baggie and take it on the plane with you. And you can put some cosmetics in there as well because as long as it fits and it will close in the Ziploc baggie, you can take it on the plane. So that's really great and kind of makes everything easy. Every single thing is under 3 ounces, which is the rule with airlines. Each individual thing has to be under 3 ounces. So Blair's dog is barking really loud. The next product I tweeted about, and it's my new shampoo I've been loving, and it's called Simply Smooth Extend Keratin Replenishing Shampoo. It looks like this. And it actually got exploded on by my deep conditioner because I checked it through when I traveled last week. And yeah, so it has like sticky stuff all over it, which kind of stinks, but this is actually a shampoo that is for use after you get a keratin treatment, which I've never had done to my hair. But when I went in to get my extensions checked out, because it was like my 5-week checkup or something, I ran out of my shampoo that came with my extensions. And so I asked her if they had more and she said no, but she recommended this. And so I tried it. It smells amazing. It smells kind of like pina colada and cupcakes. And the smell lingers in your hair, which is really nice. And it just, I love it. It makes my hair soft and manageable and not tangled, and it smells nice. And it says it is to work with the Simply Smooth Brazilian Keratin Treatment, but like I said, I didn't have the treatment. I just use the shampoo and I love it. Next favorite is my new NARS Powder Foundation. I use the color Fiji, if anyone's wondering. And it looks like this. It's just a powder. And actually, I was kind of a little bit cautious to use a powder foundation because I use liquid foundation and I don't want my foundation to look cakey. So a lot of times powder foundations are very thick and they do cake up on your face. But the makeup artist that was using this one explained to me that when you have a liquid foundation and you want it to look flawless, or maybe it's one shade too dark or too light for you, you found the perfect foundation, but it doesn't have the perfect color for you, this foundation just kind of like blends it into your skin, melts it into your skin, and makes it look flawless. So I just buff it over with like a really big powder brush, really lightly. I don't use a lot at all because, again, I don't want it to look cakey. And I love it. I use it over my Laura Mercier foundation that I'm still using and loving, and I'm obsessed with it. It's the Silk Cream Foundation. The color I use is Rose Ivory. I'm NW20. Next favorite is a NYX blush, and this is an Angel. And it's a light pink. It's kind of dusty because I use it like all the time. I have it on right now, although you might not be able to tell in this lighting. It's just a really soft porcelain doll pink. And it reminds me of Well Dressed from MAC, but it's a little bit more pigmented than Well Dressed. Well Dressed is really sheer and you kind of have to pack it on. Whereas with this one, it's really, really nice and it blends really well. I love it. It was really inexpensive. And then I have another NYX product that I love. I was sent this one and it's a NYX Lip Lacquer Pot in Georgia Peach. And that's what it looks like. I have it on right now. And it kind of reminds me of Tender Tones from MAC. It's just a really soft moisturizing balm and the color is gorgeous. It's very natural and it's kind of opaque. Mine's kind of worn off, but I really love this stuff. Next favorite is a moisturizer and eye cream combo. These are by Bobbi Brown, and I actually got to meet with her a couple of weeks ago when I went to New York, and she recommended this for my skin. She noticed my skin was very dry, and I do moisturize my skin a lot. I've used a moisturizer and an eye cream for years, but I think that, I don't know, my skin just like needs a lot of moisture. So she recommended me her hydrating face cream, which is this one. You can see I've been using it. I really, really like it. And I use this all over my face morning and night. And it's not as thick as like La Mer, which I used for a while. I love La Mer, but it's very expensive and it's not very practical for a 22-year-old. So for me, this is much more practical. I used Laura Mercier, which I really love. That was the one I used before this one. And it wasn't as thick or hydrating as this one is. And I prefer this one. And then I also am trying her eye cream, her hydrating eye cream. So it's like the same, but it's like the eye cream version, and it looks like that. I mean, I don't know why I'm showing you this, like they all look kind of the same, but the eye cream is, again, not as thick or greasy as the La Mer one. I love La Mer, I have nothing bad to say about it, but like I said, I was trying to find a more price conscious version that I really liked, and I have really been liking these. I haven't noticed any adverse skin reactions either. A lot of times with eye creams, I'll get milia underneath my eyes, which are those little like white bumpy looking things, which can make your under eye makeup look really cakey and it can irritate your eyes. I have really sensitive eyes. I have really sensitive skin in general, but I really do like these and I haven't broken out from them or anything like that. Next favorite is a NARS eyeshadow duo, and this is in Kidora. And it's these two colors. I have them on today. What I do is I put this one on first all over my lid with a, which brush am I using? I'm using the MAC 252 brush for this. And I start in my crease and I kind of work my way down like this, like pulling it down so that there's not a lot right on the base of your lid. And then I just put a little bit of the darker color right over it doing the same thing. And it kind of gives you this smoky look without it being really dark, because I think if you packed it on the lid, you would look like you had a really extravagant smoky eye on, and for everyday use, that might be a little too much. So I've really been enjoying this duo, and this is actually my sister's duo that I have been using a lot. I need to get my own because I kind of feel bad. I keep taking it from her, and I know she really likes it too. Two more favorites, and then I think we're done. Well, three, because this is two. But these are MAC Hookups, and they're these little double-sided things. So this side is a gloss in Empowerment Gold, and it's just a really gorgeous, shimmery, cream goldy gloss that would look good on anyone. And then the other side is a Get In Line Hookup Waterproof Eyeliner, and it is in Aqua. It's a bright turquoise, which you guys know I love. I don't even know if you're going to be able to see that, actually. But it's like a really vivid, bright turquoise that I love putting underneath my eyes just to give a pop of color. That's like my favorite makeup combination. And then this one has two more types of hookups. This one has a mini market stick for eyes, which is like a little pink eyeshadow in a stick. And then the other side is another gloss, and this is in Sun Luxe. And it's just a gorgeous, like, plummy pink, peachy color. It's really shimmery and really, really gorgeous, and kind of reminds me of MAC Dazzle Glass in Rags to Riches. So these are four different types of endings for the hookups. They also have brushes, which is really cool. I need to play with those and get a review out to you guys, because I think this is really cool, because you can, like, pick your different endings and throw them in your clutch. They fit in little clutches. Last favorite, I think. I got this at Ulta about 3 weeks ago, and I've really been liking it. This is Mario Badasco Drying Lotion, and it looks like this. Well, I'll show you. Like, okay, that's what it looks like. So it has like this liquidy stuff on top, and then this pink, powdery, clay-looking stuff on the bottom. And what you do is when you have like a pimple on your face, if it just pops up overnight and you're like, what are you doing? You need to go away. You stick a Q-tip all the way down. You cannot shake it. If you shake it, it all becomes a baby pink and it doesn't work. So you have to be really careful not to shake it. And I kept telling the Ulta girl, I'm like, don't put that in the bag. I'm gonna put it in my purse upright. Don't shake it. And she was like, I know. Anyway, so you stick a Q-tip straight down, you dip it in the pink, you bring it up and you dab it directly on your pimple, and you will have a little pink spot there and you will look ridiculous. So do it right before you go to bed so no one can make fun of you. Although everyone sees me, my whole family's like, yeah, she has that Mario Badasco stuff on. And it dries it up right away. Like, it might take 2 days for it to go completely away, but after 1 day, it makes a huge difference. Because it just, I don't even know what it has in it. It has alcohol, water, sulfur, salicylic acid, glycerin, zinc oxide, talc. I don't know. However it is, it works. It says, for immediate relief from unsightly whiteheads and pimples, dab one drop of the solution on each erupted area overnight. Do not shake solution. So yeah, you have to put the pink sediment stuff directly on your pimple, and I don't know what the oil stuff is, but whatever it is, it works and I love it. It's kind of expensive and I kind of hemmed and hawed over buying it, but I wanted to do a review on it and I've been wanting to try stuff from their skincare line, and so I decided to give it a shot and I like it. I think this would last like forever because I don't know how you could use that all up. So I think that was all of my favorites for this month. I'm probably going to think of more like as soon as I turn this camera off and I'm going to be mad at myself. Let's see, what else do I love? I'm loving my tan Marshalls pumps that I got in my Marshalls Back to Campus video. Those are really cute. They're by Guess. And I'm loving the song Billionaire. And I'm loving the song Cooler Than Me. I have lots of songs I'm loving right now. I can't even think of them off the top of my head. So that was my favorites video. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you want to leave a video response below, that would be great. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.